And now for the musical sample. The musical sample. Just because you're wearing a funny hat does not mean any of this blather that follows is going to be at all funny. But here we go anyway. Take it away, Magic Mark. Aye, aye, aye. Howdy everyone, it's me, Magic Mark, coming to you from the bunker system. Do I have any peanut butter cookie on my face? Howdy everybody, it's me, Magic Mark, coming to you from the bunker system. It's been a while since I've done a video, but that's because I've been working on the art villa. Oh my god, there's so much to do. It's just amazing. And I wanted to do some fun things rather than just take care of the broken down stuff that breaks down. And so I'm doing some mosaics with just some tile I had laying around the house and on the back porch, because some of the brick blew up. Much of the brick in the house is blown up. Anyway, I ripped out the last parts, there's other brick there, anyway. But the last parts, I'm doing mosaics on.
What the hell? Who cares what you...
Hey, it's me, Manic Mark, coming to you from the bunker system. I'm cutting into this video wearing this funny hat that I made. Because, I found more records, okay. And I it's the struggle between wearing the hat and acting my age, and the hat won. They're breaking into the, just breaking into it again. I don't know, anyway. I've got more records, and I just couldn't bring myself to post anything. I don't know. I'm just going crazy. And let's just break right into a story, okay? The paint story. Some of you may already know it, but those of you who don't, I always keep, like, the paint can, 5 gallon bucket of paint, so that I know what color I paint the house. I can go and say, make this color. So I'm looking for it the other day and I cannot find it. And I spent a lot of time. I looked like 30 times around. I just walked circles looking. There's not that much space here. I know it looks kind of jammed up, but I know where stuff is, okay. So I'm like, what? I don't know what. So I go and I get a paint chip off the house. I go to the paint store, Home Depot, all right? And I go to the Baird for the store brand, and I pick the chips, and I go up and I say to this chip, I say, make me a 5 gallon bucket of this paint. And the guy says, I can't do that. I said, what do you mean? He says, they don't make the deep base in 5 gallons anymore. And it dawned on me, that's why I couldn't find the 5 gallon bucket, because when I painted the house last, or part of the house last, I had to buy gallons, okay? So I knew exactly where the paint was, if I had any, where it would be. But there I am at the hardware store, so I'm like, it looks really close to my, you know, the chip and the paint chip. I'm just going to go ahead and make 5 gallons of it. And I need a quart of this color, and I pointed out, and a quart of this color. And I said, okay, I'm going to go pick up a few more things. I'll be back in about 10 minutes. It's fine. I go around the store, I come back, there's 5 gallons of paint sitting on the countertop, and the guy's still working on the order. He opens one of the gallons, he takes his finger to get a little paint, and he puts it on top, and it's green. Green was one of the quart. And I looked at him, I said, a whole gallon of green? And he said, what? I said, no, a quart of green. And he went, oh. I said, are all these gallons of paint green? Yes. I did not say 5 gallons of green paint quart. So he hadn't even made the other paint. Oh my god. I felt really so bad. He just like, I felt really bad. So he mixes the other paint. I said, you know, listen, I'll pay for one of the green gallons of green. I'll probably use it somehow. And he just, I kept saying, he calmed down a little bit. He could tell he's ready to snap. He calmed down and said, no, that's just crazy. He kept saying, that's just crazy. I'm like, hey, okay. So I get home and I find the paint. I knew where I was. I went right to it. I picked it up. I opened it. I opened the new paint, and they're not anywhere near alike. I hope I don't run out of steam before I finish them. Anyway, okay. Got some records, and what's going on? I'm thinking about stopping drinking Bud Light Lime. You know, they changed the way they sell the cases, and you can't make borders out of them anymore for paintings because the material is cheap. It's not the high quality Bud Light Lime case cardboard quality material that I'm used to. So anyway, never mind. That's the paint store. I got to get more paint. Tomorrow, it'll be fun. Okay, now, what else is going on? That's it. I'm going right to the records because that story took too long. More records, that is. James Cleveland, On a Hill, gospel record on Savoy. Just a gown. I almost Alcaola, tough guitar, Tijuana style. There's a cover of Thunderball on this record, done in like a Tijuana Mexicali kind of. I don't know. It's Brother Juniper. He's a Franciscan. He made his own record titled, Do You Know My Name? Another record, I don't know, I may have had it. It was a dollar. I picked it up. It's some kind of folk gospel album, I think. Oh my God. You know, my wife's got a fancy car, and the battery needed dead, because the car sat. Long story, but the battery needed to be replaced, okay? So it's like, okay, pop the hood. I'll put my trickle charger on the battery. Okay, pop the hood. We're looking. Where's the battery? Get the manual out. It's a fancy car, so there's nothing in the manual. Well, actually, they show a diagram of how to jump it, okay? So I found a few little places, special places for putting the jumper cables. But no battery. I had to get on YouTube to find out that the battery... You got to get into the trunk, you got to lift the thing up, and then there's a plastic thing that's got two little plastic screws. That pops up over on the right-hand side behind the wheel. And there's the battery in the trunk, hidden. Weird. Okay, are you ready? It's Paul Quinlan. Love and a Question. I don't like the cover. There's just, hey, little boy, what you doing? You know what I'm saying? Just, I'm thinking, you know, anyway, things change. That's the other reason to make this video, is I'm just not... I read the book that Steve Chandler told me to read 3 years later. This looks awesome. It's a very clean copy of a Cheesecake covered Dance Party Time. Electric Fireworks, Let's Make It, Live Cream, Troubled Earth, Heavy... And other songs. That's fun. Okay, so I did that, and then the thing broke on my lawnmower, and I fixed that, and I was pretty happy with that. Then it broke again, because what I did, I fixed it welding. Was it? Stop. Go on. I'm just going to go right to the records. A Lovely Way to Spend an Evening with Billy Butterfield. That's a sweet cover. Is that RCA? Yeah, 1958 RCA. Manipulate prices, you know, to make what they've got hold value and increase in value. That's what I found interesting about it. The self-taught art thing, I don't know anything about this, but I love the purple tuxes. Art. I'm going to be giving away some of my artwork. Don't ask me. One person is getting a painting. I got to find time to pack it. I've been trying to find ways to talk about why I'm not doing art. And this, I couldn't believe I found this. And I've seen this before. I don't know if I've got it or not. I don't think I do. I'm pretty sure I don't. Or maybe I found the album and there wasn't a record inside of it, but I remember the cover. This is a Modern Sound covers album. These are teenagers they found somewhere and they stuck them up against a brick wall and made them wear wigs on their heads. Just like the Beatles. just when I find records, I'm going to do video. Oh, I wanted to say that the experience the bite of the dinosaur idea. Bernie Richards. Society is my beat. A minty fresh... Oh yeah. I just happened to be taking the wife to a doctor's appointment, and we stopped at a Goodwill, but it was a donation center. And there were all sorts of people sorting through crap on the inside, but the lady was nice enough to say, if you go down here and turn and you go up here, there's a Goodwill. So we did that. And they had a bunch of records. I was surprised. And these records came from there. So maybe later. Anyway, read the book. And I'm going to give away art, like I said, give away some art, because I'm a hoarder. Not really. No, my wife didn't hear me say that. A mini fresh copy of Latin Dance Party. Okay, I've got two of these, but I don't know if I've got a mini fresh one. I do now. That's just a wonderful cover. Bridge Over Troubled Waters, the Addams Brothers. This is local. I don't have that. There's the Addams Brothers right there. Pete Palmer. I may have had this in the past. I'm not sure. A Swingin' Dance Day. The extra stuff I thought would... So anyway, to the records, I think I'm going to save this one for last because that's kind of cool. I'm going to go through them real fast. The theme from Thunderball, the Mexicali Brass. Don't know if this was any good. I've got a copy, but I can't remember if the copy I got is any good either, so I got another copy. Burt Comfort album, Hold Me. And a sealed copy of Dora Hall's Once Upon a Tour, okay? This is one of her TV shows. This comes from one of her TV shows that her husband paid for. I always get the story screwed up. Her husband was the president of Solo Cups, paper products. And he paid for his wife to make records. And big bucks, like $100,000 or whatever, to make at least one TV special, maybe two. And there she is. And there it is. A sealed copy. Apparently the dinosaur exhibit is a resounding success. Even without my experience the bite of the dinosaur prop. Interactive prop. And me, Manny Mark, dressed up as a dinosaur walking around scaring children. They didn't get back to me on those ideas. Because I guess they didn't need them, because the exhibit's enough to bring in the money that they need to, you know, recoup so they can bring in another exhibit. Oh well. Anyway, the Gospel of Lions, right there. There's the Gospel of Lions on the back. The Sound of Latin Brass, Budget on Medallion. I clicked a few of these. It's the reviewer copy, not for sale. To be lucky to be able to sell it. I'm telling you what, they're usually not that good. But this could be go against the what I know. There's a cover of Taboo. Peggy Lee and George Shearing. This is a live concert recorded at the Jockey Convention in Miami, Florida. Right there. It's Power Pack. It's another covers record. Hollywood Studio Symphony Orchestra conducted by Mitchell Powell. Organ Spectacular, okay? I'm kind of like pulling back from organ records, but it's on Liberty. It's on Liberty. Cover art on Liberty Records is usually better than what this, you know, this is, but because it's on Liberty, I'm taking a chance because Liberty always had great records. Satan Takes a Holiday is on this album. I forgot where I was, so let's go right to the records. Okay, the first record in this batch is by John Gary. You've seen John Gary albums in the dollar bin, which is where this came from. Many, many of them. I don't buy them, you don't buy them, nobody buys them. But I bought this one. Why? Because the title of the album is Holding Your Mind. And it's in kind of like that psychedelic, swirly... what's the swirly, whirly pool, you know, psychedelic type. And he does covers of MacArthur Park and Little Green Apples. So basically what I'm saying is this is one of those albums that people that came out of the 50s recording mood music and torch and lounge type, easy listening stuff, decided that they need to get hip, and they all made a record. Maybe this is John's, where he tries to get with the times. And usually the results are highly interesting. At the organ on Chorale, fun cover. And another covers record, Super Hits. Always nice covers on vintage top albums. In this case, Lena Horne. Super Hits by, and it's so, I don't think I've got this one. The copy on these albums are so funny. The hits and heavies of today, Flick the Dial, Let the Sound Lay on You, Jazz Rock, Blasting Big and Wild, Funky. Eddie Davis and Charlie Ventura. I've got a Charlie Ventura record on Tops that has a really great cover. He was a jazz artist. This is going to be some kind of jazz art album on King Records. The Heavy Sounds Coming In, Music of Woodstock Nation, The Black Beautiful Sounds from the Ghettos of America's Shame. It's Bobby V. I don't know who Bobby V is. I have a notion that he was a 50s crooner, kind of teen pop singer kind of guy. And in this album, he decides to get hip, so he's got kind of the sparkly, you know, LSD background. I'm not making this up. Head Music from the Golf via Mill Valley and the Strip. Getting the groovy feeling all over. Good Vibrations Coming Down. Super Hits are like the sounds you dig right on. The Singing Chariots. The Singing Chariots. Well, there they are. The Singing Chariots. Be Free. Dig the way these cats make it happen. Here's Every Mother's Son. Ain't It a Drag? That's right. I remember the tune. 50 cents. I picked it up. Pete Kelly Blues. Another one. Pete Kelly Blues, Pete Kelly and his Big Sevens, 1959. I've got 2-3 covers of that. Anyway, Les Larry, it's not a person. It's a brother and a brother. It's two brothers. Instant Replay, sounds like an original, maybe better. Open up your head to their thing with someone else's music. It's a commune for hit freaks. A Julie London album. This was not in the dollar bin. I think I paid about $6 for this one. That's a great cover. Julie looks fabulous. She's still, 2,000 or 3,000 records later, still one of my favorite, not my favorite vocalist from the period. People Who Dig Talent, Message, Love, King's Road are street people. King's Road are the sounds that talk to us. They say something. Jack McDuff, Good Night, It's Time to Go on Prestige. The notes read as though this was his first album, and I didn't look him up online. I know nothing about him. Don't know if he made any more records. Don't know if he's well known or not, but I like the cover, so I picked it up because of the tough looking cover. And a mini fresh copy of George Gates' dynamic album, Polynesian Percussion. This is a great exotic album. And I've got 2 copies of it, but I don't know if I've got the Sensational Stereo percussion copy. Take mention, she held up, she did mention, Pete Rugolo album. And apparently he made a number, and I may have one, I hope it's not this one, but this is his experimental brass album that he made for Mercury. 10 exciting experiments in converting a brass section into a complete orchestra. I hope I don't have this one. Here's a press. A guy's name I'm not even going to try to pronounce. I've got 3 or 4 of his albums. I don't have this one. This one's interesting because it's on Roulette. It's on a budget label. So, and I don't know if my copy is clean. I think I had to skip it. Organ Melodico. Organ Melodico. Dusty Springfield's Golden Hits. This is a great cover. This is a private press out of the Midwest. They're out of the Midwest, but it's a German group. There's bilingual notes on the back. They do some a rumba, a cha-cha, calypso, a swing. But look at the photo. It's like they're characters out of a Bela Lugosi movie, D. Juan Torres. It's a fun cover. There's two people, stock art, and they've got some kind of tiki head. Something that looks like a tiki head. Razzmatazz. This is one of those albums you think, Razzmatazz, that's got to be 200's fl-. I think I already have this record. But I couldn't remember, and it was a dollar, so I picked it up. I don't know. It's from Honolulu. It's a gatefold. Somebody spent a lot of money on it. Now, when I was checking out at Half Price Books, the board clerk was like flipping through, counting up, and then they got to this one, stopped and looked at me. It's a two-record set, Do the Hustle. It's a how-to record, how to do the hustle, two-record set. There's a lot of photographs on the front of people doing various versions of the hustle. She looked at me and I went... One of the songs is La Bikina. Is that the bikini? I don't know. And last but not least, it's a sealed copy, and I urge you to sit down before I show you the cover. I believe this is a classical music album, but flute and guitar kind of grabbed me, and even classical music done that way. I think I like it, so I picked it up. Jimmy Page apparently did a soundtrack. I don't keep up with stuff like that. Death Wish 2. And last but not least, why was it in this order? I don't know. It's Bud Shank. Nobody knows who he is. Maybe some of you do. I don't know. Two or three albums maybe he made. Anyway, I found one. This is another one. He covers Monday Monday in Norwegian Wood. It's Charles and Francis Hunter. Charles and Francis. I don't know who's Charles and who's Francis, but there they are on the cover of two slack key guitars. It's an island record. Where are they from? Probably Hawaii. Yes, Hawaii. Two guys playing guitars. This looks totally awesome. New Kick. The new Christie Minstrels, okay? It's a great cover. There's a great photograph of some kind of weird space age fashion chick on the front. Which should be not bad, anyway. God is fabulous. At Goodwill, it's crazy, but I found a Arthur Lyman album, Colorful Percussions Of. I may or may not have that one. I can't remember. It's Somerset Budget, some kind of budget studio band doing some big band stuff, but the cover is kind of nice. Late 50s, I think. And last but not least, hadn't seen this record, although I look for spy theme records. They're a lot of fun. In this case, Super Spy Themes by the Clichés. You can go and click on the link below and listen to a really fabulous cover of the Get Smart theme from Get Smart, done by the Clichés. There's a link to it right down below.
She looks down as she flies on by, riding in the air so easy in the sky. But Lordy, look at me here. I'm rooted like a tree here. Yeah, I got them sit down. Sun comes along, lights up the day, and when he gets tired, he slows down all the way. Mm-hmm. had a gal. Lord, she was blind. She never saw the sun, but Lord, she never stopped trying. Then one day, my gal.